An exclusive presentation of Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports.
Hi, we're Sugarland. Welcome to Tampa, Florida.
Enjoy the ride. Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports.
The Atlantic Coast Conference tournament's spending this week in the Tampa Bay area, but today the beach relatively empty. They're moving inside the St. Pete Times Forum, where you can even find a little North Carolina barbecue. The top seed North Carolina is here today. Freshman Brandon Wright ready for his first ACC tournament. Yesterday's hero for Florida State, Al Thornton, is here. That is the first matchup. The tournament's top seed, the North Carolina Tar Heels, 25-6 on the year, taking on Florida State, upset winner over Clemson yesterday. And how about the 12 seed Miami Hurricanes? They'll face Boston College in the second game today. Welcome to the ACC Tournament, everybody. I'm your host, Mike Hogwood. We'll be here through Championship Day on Sunday. And if it's anything like yesterday today, take a deep breath. You are really in for something. Al Thornton, 25 points, 11 rebounds, leading Florida State to a win over Clemson. Jack McClinton had a big day for Miami. They upset Maryland. Brandon Koster yesterday, 30 points. State beat Duke in overtime. And speaking of overtime, how about double OT and Harvey Hale, 21 of his 22 points for Wake as they beat Georgia Tech. Here are Toyota brackets, and the way it lineups today, you'll see all the games right here. North Carolina, Florida State, Boston College in Miami. Then tonight, it's Virginia and North Carolina State, Virginia Tech, and Wake Forest. Now, my partner up here on the perch is Cliff Ellis. And Cliff, I know you're ready for another day just like yesterday.
Well, I'm telling you what, I've been following ACC basketball for a long time. I've never seen anything like yesterday. The spoilers had their way, starting with Al Thornton running amok to Harvey Hale having a hailstorm. It was quite a day. If it gets any better than that, I don't know if I can stand it.
Me either, Coach. All right, let's focus in on today's first game, North Carolina, Florida State. Cliff, let's get your four keys to the game.
Four keys to the game for Florida State. Take the basketball to Al Thornton inside. Let him at least touch the ball. Go to Tony Douglas outside. They need his threat. For North Carolina, ride those horses inside. Hansbrough right. They need touches. They need to punch it in.
One of those horses, Tyler Hansbrough, hurt his nose in that last game against Duke. He will play but will not wear a mask. We've got the opening tip on the way from here in Tampa.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by GEICO, by your Carolina Jeep dealers, by Food Lion, by Bud Light, by Alltel, by Pepsi, and by Advance Auto Parts.
Look at the beautiful blue. This game is available in high definition. Brought to you by Raycom Sports
And Lincoln Financial Sports, check the availability in your area. All set to go. Florida State and North Carolina. And as you've heard already, all the lower seeds won. How do these two teams match up, Billy?
Well, they played only once this year, back to that unbalanced schedule situation. North Carolina, to be quite honest with you, had no problem with Florida State, particularly in the second half, but they just blew them out. Entirely different circumstance here.
Where does the adrenaline go away and fatigue become a factor for the lower seeds?
Well, I don't think there'll be any lack of adrenaline part of Florida State. This is a game that they can assure themselves an NCAA tournament bid. If they don't win this ball game, they're going to be sitting there Sunday afternoon wondering, are they going to get in or not? Kind of like last year's situation.
Let's check the Food Lion's starting lineups. First for Florida State, Al Thornton at 25 points. He is certainly the catalyst. Swan, Tony Douglas gets the start today. Rich and Enchufu, that rounds out the Seminoles starting five. And for the Tar Heels, Brandon Wright, Rookie of the Year, Wayne Ellington, Frazier, Terry, and Hansbro. Let's go over to Scott Przewanski. Scott, what do you have?
Yeah, well, let me pick up on what Billy said, and that is that Leonard Hamilton says, you know what, we did win yesterday. Everyone's telling us we might be in, but he's not taking anything for granted. You know, he was burned on that last year, so he said, I'm not worried about things I can't control when I can't control our wins and losses, and that's how he's approaching this. As for North Carolina, it's the most nose that has ever been talked about in the country, and that belongs to Tyler Hansbro. Now, Hansbro wore a mask throughout practice earlier this week and had an adjustment period. Interestingly enough, he did not wear it during warm-ups today, but came out of the locker room and has it on. We'll see how or if it affects his play.
The officials, Mike Wood, Les Jones, Roger Ayers, Ron Mouzay, and Carolina will have it first. Man-to-man defense by Florida State.
Thornton on right.
Hansbro's first shot is short. And a foul.
Well, that was a really good tap back from behind. Florida State had an easy two with Douglas on a break had that not been a foul. You know what? It's going to be interesting to me, Tim. You were a football player. Wearing a helmet or not wearing a helmet, as far as having that full visibility.
Well, I agree.
And it's going to be really interesting to see how Hasbro today, how he handles this mask situation.
What?
Does he have the peripheral vision? Does it handicap him as far as his running up and down the court?
And the first bucket by Ellington. And Carolina has the lead. And Billy, that's an excellent point. And to me, not warming up with it tells me he doesn't like it.
Yeah, I think as tough as he is, unless the doctors say he must keep it on, he's the kind of guy that'll say, you know, I'm taking this thing off and it hampers him. Not the same degree as Thornton's headband, but remember yesterday he said, I'm taking the headband off. It has nothing to do with his physical abilities, but you see Hasbro. He has no problem whatsoever sticking it in there.
So Hasbro answers the bucket by Rich, and it's 5-2.
And if you're Florida State, what you have got to do in this type of ball game is to stay close. You are not going to blow North Carolina out of the ball game. You've got to stay close, play your game as long as you can.
Thornton's shot is short.
And Wright really provides a tough job when he switches off from Terry. No matter who he goes to, it's hard getting a jumper over him with those long arms.
Lawson picks up his dribble. Terry with a nice entry pass. How about that?
You're right, Tim. A terrific entry pass. Exactly where it had to be thrown. Perfect speed in there. Great feed to the post.
And Wright knows how to finish.
There it is. Not Terry on Thornton, but Wright on him.
Only one-hander by Thornton won't go. And Billy, you're right. This is a dangerous time, even though it's the beginning of the ball game, because Florida State wants to stay close.
Good rebound by Ellington.
And the foul. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
I've watched Ellington progress as a player, not only as a rebounder, but defensively. He has really improved himself in areas of weakness this year. Watch that feed. Perfect pass down inside, right on exactly the spot where he can catch it with two hands and finish it. I don't know if I've seen a freshman finisher any better than Wright.
Billy, the foul is on Enchufu. That's his first, second team foul. Ellington at the line, 80% free throw shooter.
80%, and he misses them, you're surprised. He has such a beautiful stroke.
Wright goes out of the ball game, and Dean Thompson comes in for Carolina.
He's having all kinds of pants adjustment. I think his pants were falling down on him. He's kind of laughing sitting over on the bench, but
That's about the only adjustment he's had to make so far.
You don't want to come out of the game, though, 2.5 minutes into the tournament.
Thompson in the ballgame now. He shows he's an excellent post-up player, and he is going to be playing on Thornton defensively. I'm kind of surprised at that. Thornton ought to take him outside where he's not versed at playing on the perimeter.
Thornton 0 for 2. We'll see how long the headband lasts. Back to Adjafu. Nice feed.
Good cut by the big man.
Ellison.
How about that crossover?
Back to Ellison. This is for three.
And that's what you don't want to do if you're Florida State. Tremendous catch.
Thompson with a rebound. Ball's still loose. And the foul is called.
Tim, there was an example for Ansbrough as you're catching that long ball. But if that face mask is going to bother you, that would have been the kind of pass that you'd have trouble with. But he had no trouble getting his hands on it. Great look right into the hands on the catch.
So Schwann picks up the personal. Boy, Lawson had that look at the open three, couldn't finish. Couldn't get it to go down. This is Green.
Good post-up position by Hansbrough.
And they're going to call Hansbrough for the offensive.
I didn't like that call at all. He had excellent position on the inside. Gets called for the foul. That's what a big man's supposed to do, is to get some position. And Roy Williams reaching me there. He's just shaking his head. He can't believe it. And, you know, that's what we teach him to do.
9-4, Carolina early. Douglas for three. Air ball.
He had a good look at that shot. Thornton wanted him to hit the ball inside. When they played the first time, that was a real problem for Florida State. 4 for 15 for three, only 34%. They were out-rebounded by 12. And in the second half, North Carolina pulled away. They had a 20-point advantage in the second half, 48-28. Right now, I think that, as Cliff said, they better get Thornton some touches both inside and out. He's going to have a monster game today if Florida State were to beat North Carolina.
Really right back in the ballgame. Hansbrough gets a breather.
Telegraph pass.
Back. Lawson picks it off.
Oh, what hands.
And Ellington finishes.
Caught that ball, thrown behind him, and still had control.
Florida State needs a timeout. Down 11-4. 16-21 to play first half. We'll return after this message from the ACC. Here's that last play again. Great pass, terrific catch. And the finish.
It really was. You're going right to the basket, and the ball is thrown behind you. To be able to reach back, catch it, and then still make the soft layup is a terrific play by Ellington.
And he's got 7 of Carolina's 11 points.
Tim, something kind of interesting, and this is hard to believe. The last time that North Carolina was seeded number one in the tournament and won the championship, 1982.
That is unbelievable.
And, you know, of course, that was the great James Worthy, Michael Jordan, Sam Perkins team, but 1982 seems like that's impossible to believe. They haven't won the title since 98. It'll be a long drought for them.
Well, Carolina's shooting well here early and also with the second chance points. Ball's loose, tie up, possession arrow belongs to Florida State.
Nice job by the big man Wright going down on the floor. And I mentioned before, in a game like this, let's face it, North Carolina is the superior team. The only way Florida State wins this game, in my opinion, is if Thornton has a game that just is unbelievable. I'm talking about a 37 points, 12 rebounds, unstoppable. Because there are not enough parts in this Florida State team to handle North Carolina. Is he capable of doing that? The answer is yes, really. I don't think so.
So far, he's 0 for 2.
One more shot that he misses, the headband comes off.
Douglas having a hard time with the ball early. He's had a couple turnovers. Florida State's got 3 turnovers early, and they find themselves down 11-4. Another great day in Tampa, Florida. Second day of the ACC tournament. Stay with us.
Without question, the North Carolina have a tremendous group of freshman players. There's Wright with his ability to finish inside. Lawson to Ellington.
as good a freshman backcourt as you'll ever want to see. And there's Wright back out on the floor. As I said, the only adjustment he had to make today is his pants fell off and he had to sit down for a few minutes. But he's in pretty good shape right now. There's that freshman scoring. Fourth all-time in regard to freshman classes. That number one up there, Duke, was the great Johnny Dawkins class. Billison Allery in that class eventually got all the way to the final game when they were seniors. Hopefully these guys will have an opportunity to experience that as well.
Here's the rebound situation. Carolina just dominating so far. The headband now is off.
He didn't have to miss another shot. Well, the headband worked for Thornton yesterday, but taking the shoes off at halftime didn't work for Maryland.
No,
they were
didn't.
Stuck in cement in the first half, and even with different
they
shoes,
stayed there. You're right. See if that timeout helped Florida State. They really need to get going here. You know, they shot around 50% from the field in their ACC wins this year. Right now, just 2 for 5. Get a turnover here, and here's Thornton. Maybe this will get him going.
Now, with Terry, probably as good as. Wow! That'll get him going. Size for size, Terry athletically is about as close to physical matchup as Thornton can have in the league, and he just took him to school.
Rashad Terry fouled by Rich. That's the first on Rich.
That was some move. You start talking about who is the best player, not necessarily the most valuable, but the best player in the ACC. You're looking at him right there. That is some move. One thing I want to point out, you know, he's a fifth-year senior. He came into Florida State as a freshman, sat out that first year, actually came in the second semester. So he has got all the experience and the natural maturation process has taken place. He's improved his game, and right now he is one touch play.
This is Ellington for three. Halfway down, comes back out, and over the top goes Wright for the personal foul. Billy, when you're talking about Thornton, just the way he glides, the way he jumps, reminds me of David Thompson. You don't see it.
Well, he's much bigger and stronger than David was.
But he's got that flow to him, that athleticism.
David exploded off the floor, and I think went higher than does Thornton. But we're talking about two pretty fair players. David, of course, playing on great teams.
Yeah, absolutely.
Get out of here.
And look at how Thornton's respecting Wright's long reach, not trying to take that jump shot that he'd normally take off of a smaller man.
Thornton is fouled by Lawson. The reach in.
What I like about what Thornton's doing right now, he realizes that his team cannot win without him having a big game.
Yeah.
He's starting to really explode. You know, it was interesting yesterday, too. He made that key foul shot that won the ball game against Clemson. Reading in the paper this morning, he said it's the first time he ever had to be on the foul line to win a game.
Said he was nervous.
Yeah, he said he was very nervous and missed the first one, and then buried the second one for the win. Here comes a trap by North Carolina. Ellington just a little bit shy of getting it.
Douglas takes it to the hoop and was right there and couldn't make the bucket.
Oh, Frazier makes a steal after having a fumble.
And Thornton picks up a personal.
Frazier kind of laughing at himself because he had a great fast break opportunity for his club. But he fumbles the ball. Now he makes a steal and it gets fouled.
We bragged on the athleticism of Thornton, then he couldn't pick up the basketball. Carolina just 2 points over the last 3:45.
Got away from going inside. Let's see if they get back to it.
Terry's jumper, good.
In the first game between these two teams, Terry did not score. He was 0 for 5 from the field. He had 7 rebounds in that ball game, but was not able to score.
Jumper by Gerald Allen.
Allen hit that big jumper yesterday, remember, to get them going against Clemson. Thornton grabbed Wright by the shirt. Got by with it.
Another turnover. Rich will go to the line to shoot two.
Foul on Terry, never got to the spot.
Well, let's take a look at the Q Motor Oil Power 25 with Carolina, Maryland, and Duke. UCLA lost. I still believe they get a number one seed out west.
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
No, I really think that if...
Who did you put out there as
the
number one seed?
I'll tell you what. I think the people that are alive that can take the number one seeds. As example, North Carolina is still alive. You have Kansas still alive. You have Ohio State still alive. I think you have Florida still alive. I think if those teams were to win their conference championship tournament, I think those are the four seeds.
Carolina or UCLA still has toughest schedule, highest RPI. Out of all of those teams you mentioned, it's still the talent, I think, is the number one seed in the West.
Well, Timmy, I really think that this committee went to Indianapolis this week with about seven and maybe even eight teams with a possibility of getting into a number one spot. And I think that these conference championships, even at that line, are going to be more important than they've ever been before. And if you sit down and say, okay, North Carolina could win an ACC as an example, or Ohio State can win theirs, or a Kansas or a Florida, it's hard to say we're going to pick a team that lost their last regular season game plus the first round of their conference tournament.
Selection committee says they also take into account the area of geographical interest from certainly UCLA in the West.
And Hansbrough missing that jumper, but that's part of his game that I think we're going to see more of in the future.
Thornton misses the dunk. Here's Etchefu. He can't get it. Thornton again. And lost out of bounds.
And there was the sequence for the first time that I think the mask is affecting Hansbrough. He did not stick his face right in this traffic. Watch it here. See if he... Normally, he is right in the middle of that pack.
And the turnover carried it. That's five turnovers now for Carolina.
We'll say this for Florida State. They're hanging in there, which is the key of what to do, primarily because North Carolina had them in a situation to put them away and haven't gotten it done.
And they've closed the gap, playing better since the timeout by Leonard Hamilton.
Get your shirt down, 15. Come on.
So, you heard some substitutions as Breeden comes in. He wasn't even on the floor yet. He was being chastised by the officials.
I kind of like that. You know, you heard it. It was out without any question. Get your shirt in there, 15. Come on.
That's Mike Wood, the official.
I like that.
Red, Ralph.
Trying to dress him up to standards.
But you're going to play in this tournament, look like you belong.
3-point game, 12:34 to play, first half. Tim Brandt, Billy Packer with you, courtside.
Thornton sitting down for the first time. Where do the points come from?
There they go again, and again, they get the big bucket from Allen.
Tie score. Nice job by Florida State to act like they belong here.
Allen now with 5 points.
Florida State being very aggressive on the reach-ins.
Allen with a steal. Mims into the paint.
Mims looks quick, doesn't he?
Frazier ahead to right. Frazier will take the three from way outside.
That was a terrific job by Wright. Makes the catch in traffic, realizes he doesn't have good position, and fires back out to the open man. It's good to see. Guys work together like that. Terrific job by Frazier, who has really been hampered by injuries this year.
Carolina by three. Hansbrough with the rebound. Frazier will push it.
This is as quick as I've seen Frazier play in a number of weeks.
Right turnaround, yes.
Wright raised his fist to come out again. Maybe he has something that's bothering him. He's played limited minutes.
Allen looks for help. Good hands by Wright to knock it out of Breeden's hands. 18-13, Carolina. 10:57 to play first half. 25 years of covering the ACC, and it just gets better and better. Take a look at Carolina, the history they have with rookies of the year. First, Marvin Williams, 2005. Tyler Hansbrough, 2006. And this year, Brandon Wright. 15 points, 66% from the field, and almost two blocks a game.
There's the old freshman team. Yeah, what was interesting, preseason, Brandon Wright did not get any votes for the preseason all-freshman team, ends up as the freshman of the year in the conference. And that was probably because there were so many guys that that had that opportunity. Nice Young of Georgia Tech was picked as preseason rookie of the year.
Billy, I think you're one of the most talented freshman classes this conference has seen.
I would agree, and particularly when the Big Ten are concerned. Thornton back out on the floor, being guarded by Thompson.
Thornton's jumper in front of the rim. Carolina's gone 5-0 run since it was tied at 13.
You have the two freshman big men in there, Stevenson and Thompson. Both operate pretty well together because you probably figure in practice they work a lot of minutes in tandem.
Lawson gets it back, gets it over Miller for the three.
Excellent three-point shooter when he can get set and have time. Last year, he was outstanding. Worked his way into a starting position. Had trouble this year with his shot early on, but I think he's now more comfortable, not worrying about having to take the shot.
Miller made his first start of the year against Duke the other day. Here's the steal again. Finally, Thompson gets it to Gifford.
So that's the shot he was trying to take earlier in the year, where he's really not capable. And he'll get that standstill jumper, and he can hit him. He's rushed. He has a more difficult time.
21-13, Carolina. Florida State again on the ropes.
Rich yesterday had a terrific ball game. Really exploded to the basket on numerous occasions.
Mims brings it back out, calls the offense. Got 10 on the shot clock.
Step out for Thornton. There he is down the lane. Good hands.
Has it blocked. And the foul. Thompson.
I think it's going to be Stevenson coming out behind Thornton. Didn't really realize he was there.
Our Chevrolet stars of the tournament from yesterday are Al Thornton, Florida State, had that big game. And Brandon Costner of North Carolina State and the win over Duke.
Of course, Costner, like Thornton, sat out in his freshman year, so this is really his second year at NC State, but really outstanding player. He can step outside. He's got good moves to the basket. Terrific body on him. He is, without question, going to be one of the premier players, not only in the league, but in the country in the future.
Hansbrough, Ellington, and Wright come back into the ball game for Carolina.
This North Carolina team is really deep and talented. And I know that it's gone back and forth. Are they playing too many people? When are they playing them? I think Roy Williams, obviously a great coach, knows what he wants to do with the team. And I think it depends on who you're playing. They were very effective with a very deep team playing against the likes of Duke. They could not go deep. It wasn't as effective playing against the Georgia Tech. They basically come in with a lot of athletes in depth.
Lawson got caught in the air. Florida State comes right back with it. This is Rich. And Rich throws it away. Thought Swan was going to backdoor.
Now, Swan faked his own teammate out. He really had the way to go backdoor. There was nobody there to help from the weak side. Swan just changed his mind. Turnover will go to Rich, but it was really Swan the one that created the turnover.
Five turnovers for Florida State. It's tough to beat the number one seed when you're giving the ball away.
I just, as I said at the top, I don't think they have enough firepower unless Thornton just takes the game over.
Hansbrough comes all the way outside. Here's Wright. Back to Lawson with 10 on the shot clock.
He can break a man down off the dribble, doesn't do it there, loses it.
5 on the shot clock.
Good defense by Rich on Lawson, who can really break you down. Thornton loves to set screens and then roll off that move, outside or back in.
That's if you can't get it. Here's Thornton with the follow. How about that?
And that rebound was over Wright and Terry. Not only gets the rebound, but finishes off.
Thornton with another rebound. State making a run.
They are, but they're getting a little tired right now. You see, even Rich, who's in tremendous shape, taking his time getting down the floor. Hey. to get his breath as well.
And they throw it away. Bad pass by Douglas.
There's a case where Terry probably should have thrown that ball back to a teammate instead of trying to challenge Douglas for the layup.
I think he thought he was going over Douglas. 21-17, Carolina.
23, Tony Douglas, that's his first 50.
Without question, we're looking at a guy that has great ability, but he also gets a little nervous about certain things. He wears that headband to start the game, and his superstition tells him if it's not going well, I take it off. When he takes it off, some good things happen, just as it was yesterday.
He took it off yesterday, ended with 25.
Same deal.
Yeah.
Hey, in the first game that these two played each other, as I mentioned, Terry did not score a field goal. He's on the line right now. The key to the game was right at 20 points and 5 rebounds. Hansborough had 25 points and 13 rebounds. Another one of those explosive games. But so far, they have held him down. And I don't know about you, Tim, but I really think that and it will be discussed, I'm sure, an awful lot as this tournament goes on. That mask that he's wearing seems to really be affecting him.
Yeah, I agree. And again, he didn't warm up with it. He didn't seem comfortable with it. And that's a problem.
You notice when he has to look up in the air, his whole neck has to bend backwards as opposed to just his normal vision. Not making any excuses for him, but it seems like it is a handicap.
Meanwhile, a very good free throw shooter misses the free throws. And Florida State continues to close the gap in Carolina.
And one thing they're not doing is allowing North Carolina right now to get those breakaways where they get those 8-0 runs to take you out of the ballgame.
Strong has it blocked.
Wright was just waiting for that. He was the second man in line.
Shot clock at 3. They've got to take it. They do from beyond the arc.
Good block out by Hansbrough.
Fort Douglas had a good look. Pass to Wright. Oh, Rajafu was all by himself at the other end.
Douglas should have realized, hey, I don't have to make a hard pass here. That ball wasn't thrown with any arc on it whatsoever. He said it was his fault, but to be quite honest, I think the ball didn't have to be such a direct pass.
Douglas still trying to come back from that broken right hand, still hasn't found his rhythm.
Particularly with his shot. I thought yesterday he played a good floor game.
Almost 4 minutes since a field goal, and now Wright breaks that drought. He's got 6 points.
Have you seen anybody that can elevate and raise those arms and get the extension like he does down low? It's just so hard to stop him when he gets the ball in the low box.
How about the wingspan?
Yep.
And this is going to be an offensive foul called on Douglas. That's two.
Here we see right inside. Now watch when he just extends those arms. Even as a defensive player, you feel like you've got him under control. Then the extension comes and he's a foot and a half above your hands. Thomas into the ball, giving the backcourt now. A young man that has really played well of late. Came off those injuries to his legs.
Terry with a quick first step, and he's fouled.
I really feel that Florida State is wearing down a little bit. That game yesterday when Clemson really took them to the wire, and it seems like they're tiring out a little bit. North Carolina, blessed with the bench that they have, just comes on with fresh troops.
That was on Jason Rich. That's two on Rich. Coming up next, Miami and Boston College.
When you look over at that bench, you know, you've got Hansbrough on the bench, Lawson on the bench, Miller on the bench, Frazier on the bench, Green on the bench, Ginyard on the bench, Stevenson on the bench.
And look how quick Hansbrough got that mask off.
I know, that's a pretty good team sitting right over there.
Hansbrough got the mask off, works on it with a towel, pulls with a strap, continues to adjust it. Definitely bothering him. Terry at the line, missed his last two, and he misses this one. Terry, a 79% free throw shooter, struggling at the charity stripe. 1-for-4.
Florida State, you're hanging in here. You got it down that 5-minute mark. You just want to stay close in this ball game. Get it to the second half without having North Carolina on a big run.
And Mims is fouled. I believe it's going to be called on Thomas. It is Quentin Thomas's first. Ohio State in a battle with Michigan.
Tommy Amaker's team really looking to try to get themselves in an NCAA tournament berth. They have to win this game, I think, to get there. Ohio State, as everybody knows, an extremely difficult opponent. One of the great games of the year is when they played against North Carolina in Chapel Hill without Oden.
Etchaboo's missed a couple of those, Billy, right up top. That ball was off the official. He's part of the court.
That's all right.
That's right. He's part of the court. Here's Thornton.
Oh, what a great move there. Gave Wright too much credit.
Florida State, ice cold. Here's Thornton. All right. And the foul on Thornton.
Well, as great a dunker as Wright is, you can see Thornton really went up there hard, taking away that layup.
That's two on Thornton.
Now, you know Wright finishes about against anybody, but Thornton wasn't about to let him have that layup.
Wasn't a whole lot of contact.
That would have been some block against a player of this magnitude.
So Wright,
six times with the North Carolina having a problem with the foul line. Wright, not a good free throw shooter.
No, he's not. 55%. Carolina, 3-for-7.
But you have Ellington on the floor with one rookie of the week award. Wright was six of them, and Lawson was over on the bench, had one, so they dominated that particular polling.
Wright makes the second. It's 25-17 Tar Heels as Hansbrough comes back into the ballgame, and Wright goes out.
I think it's important if you're a backcourt player now, as Thomas is the key guy for North Carolina, get Hansbrough in the game offensively. Get him some touches down low. Let him feel more comfortable with that mascot.
Hansbrough with just 2 points.
Thornton slaps his hands to voice, I want the ball.
Here's Allen over to Mims. Thomas cheating on his right hand, knows he likes to go to the right side. And they turn it over.
Nobody came out to get the ball. Allen was late getting there, and that caused his teammate to have to travel.
Billy, that's 9 turnovers now for the Seminoles.
Well, when you consider 9 turnovers, and they're just down 8 points, not bad. But the stamina problem is starting to take place a little bit too for their club. They stayed in the game against North Carolina in the first half at Chapel Hill. It was that second half that got them.
Ellington. Yes.
And there he is with that medium range shot, long range three. And he's improved himself to be able to take the ball to the basket.
Ellington with 9 points. Carolina with its largest lead at 10.
Doing almost another walk. Doing a good job overcoming the passing lanes.
So Thomas picks up his second personal.
You know, Tim, when you think back of yesterday, and you said at the top of the show, when you look here, Florida State a 9 seed advance, Miami a 12 seed advance, North Carolina State a 10 seed advance, Wake Forest 11 seed advance. So you have a 9, 10, 11, and 12 advancing in a league that's supposed to be as strong as possible from top to bottom. Yesterday probably exemplified that more than any, but I'll tell you right now, it surprises me that the lower seeds won every single one of those games.
Nothing like college basketball. If you're celebrating the win, do it right. The way you celebrate says a lot about you and reflects on your school, so be responsible. Take care of yourself and your friends. That's a message from Anheuser-Busch.
And again, you never know how it's going to affect the selection committee, but Wake Forest Miami Mims may have really hurt the bubble teams in the ACC, because Georgia Tech and Maryland is going to be in the tournament without question, but a Florida State and a Georgia Tech could be affected by that.
Back out front, they whip it around the perimeter. Back to Lawson. This is Green beyond the arc. Splash.
Green and Ginyard, one for offense, one for defense. Green, the kind of guy you can see any ball game he gets in, if he plays enough minutes, could be a double-figure scorer.
Carolina pulling away.
And if you're Leonard Hamilton, you just want these 3 minutes to get by in a hurry. Try to get close.
Thornton for three. That'll help.
And that's what he ought to do. Thompson is not used to playing a man that far from the basket. Thornton can shoot off over the top of him.
Thornton with 9 points, Billy. Hansbrough
And now the whistle on the foul.
UNC has 9 points, but in this particular game, for Florida State to win, he's got to have 35 or more. 9 won't get it.
Well, let me tell you, he got 7 of them after he took the headband off. 2:59 to play first half. Will this get him going? Bang. One of the toughest players you'll ever see, Tyler Hansbro, the 6'9 sophomore, wearing that mask today, did not warm up with it, came out, put it on just before the tip, had it on and off when he's been out of there. Billy, you really do think it's affected him?
Yeah, I just think it's got to be very uncomfortable. There you see a little skirmish on the inside, but he hangs onto that ball, has to readjust that mask.
Certainly is conscious of it, there's no question about that.
Yep. And it just has to feel so uncomfortable for him. That was an unfortunate situation. Now he's kind of wrapping up that mask as we speak. Kind of hits hands. There was nothing that was unpleasant about that little play on the inside. What I've noticed so far is, as I said before, it seems like he has to lift his head up to see anything that's going over the top of him, like a rebounding situation.
Well, he's certainly struggling with his shooting. Let's go over to Cliff Ellis. Cliff?
Well, seeing Hansbrough with the mask reminds me of a Horace Grant story. He had the same thing, and we go into the halftime. He took it and threw it off in the locker room, threw it away. He said, I've had enough. I can't play with it. Hansbrough has not made a shot. I wouldn't be surprised to see him take it off at halftime.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised either. I mean, he looked fine when he was warming up without it.
Cliff, you mentioned a guy that may have been the toughest guy that played in the league since Hansbrough came in the league.
Well, Horace Grant had it, but Horace Grant had the same issues with regards to another situation, and he threw his goggles away. He said, Coach, I don't care what the doctor said. I cannot play with this mask. And he took it off, never played with it again at Clemson.
Turnover by Carolina.
And I think he went out and got 20-something points the next game.
Well, we'll see what he does, because nobody can question the courage of this young man. You know, it's interesting, too. You see over there on the Carolina bench, Steve Robinson, the last time Florida State got to an NCAA tournament, the assistant coach now at North Carolina was the head coach at Florida State. And also, something interesting about that team, they got into the NCAA tournament with a 6-10 conference record, which is the lowest record of any ACC team ever getting into the tournament. Steve Robinson has some association with this Florida State.
Florida State manufacturing a little bit of a run here. They've scored 5 straight points. Here's Etchefu. Breeden has a look, hesitates with the shot, and throws up an air ball.
You don't want to hesitate. Not a good pass, but a good catch.
Back to Lawson. To Green, and he'll fire from down the arc.
There's a push off on the inside by Hansbrough.
That's 2 on Hansbrough. Today's telecast is brought to you in part by Suzuki Motorcycles. Glad to have you along here in Tampa, Florida, St. Pete Times Forum. Beautiful weather down here. It's been a spectacular venue to host the tournament.
Watching Hansbrough, you know, I'm trying to keep a bead on him, and this mask is really driving him crazy. I mean, he's constantly trying to adjust it. Well, you can see him right there. Just really, you know, he also had a... In that ball game, got hit in the mouth, so I understand he's going to need some dental work there, not on that particular play, but on a different play.
You need a root canal, didn't he? Did I see that? Not pleasant.
Now, he is not enjoying having to wear that, I can tell you. It is definitely affected.
Watch how fast he gets it off.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to cut the gap to 4.
Just when you thought North Carolina was ready to go ahead and make a move with a run, Florida State hangs in there, and just what Leonard Hamilton wants. Stay close. 1:50 to go in the half.
30-26. Terry extended the arm, and that's what Rich is telling the official, but this is going to be on Rich, and that's 3 personal.
Well, Rich, that was a very good screen that time by Thompson, and Rich didn't go around the screen. It was a very legal screen. And I'm kind of surprised that the foul, Terry will be screened as opposed to Thompson. The contact really took more place with Thompson, who was setting an excellent screen.
See Carolina, an excellent free throw shooting team, but really struggling at the line today.
Struggling with with some of the guys that are pretty good free throw shooters. This one in particular.
Terry now just 1 for 5.
Terry and Hansborough both have missed free throws.
Terrell Allen, number 11, and Rich.
Jason Rich sitting down with three personals. He's not happy with that last call. Still discussing it.
Now you go back yesterday to that call that ended the ball game. I'm sure Clemson people weren't too happy with the score tied. Thornton coming off to Robin and picked up the foul.
Terry 1 for 6 at the charity strike.
Talking about the difference between a nice working margin just on missed free throws.
And there's a turnover by Florida State as Etchefu walks.
Etchefu trying to do some things he's not capable of. Now you've got Thornton on the bench right now. Minute and 31 to go. I'm surprised he's not back out there for these key possessions to end this this first half. There's Oliver Burnell.
He said he wasn't happy with the way the game ended yesterday. Just said it was disappointing. And
when you look on the floor for Florida State right now, where do the points come from with the guys that are out there?
Well, Lawson will take a three from Carolina and comes up short. Nothing scoring run in the last 2.5 minutes.
Nim is doing a smart thing. Wanted to occupy a little bit of the clock. Got himself in trouble.
He picked up his dribble. Yep.
That's a two-man point guard right here.
Swan for three. And over the back of the backboard, and so it'll be Carolina basketball. Under a minute to play. 52.7 seconds left in the first half.
North Carolina hasn't exactly played well on the offensive end either. I mean, in addition to the fouls, they have not been able to get their inside game going like they did against Florida State the first time. And Wright and Hansborough just controlled the game.
Lawson is fouled. Not a good shot. Hit the rim, and he got bailed out with the foul.
One of the things about Lawson, he goes inside. He's so powerful, he doesn't mind getting in there with the trees. It makes something happen because he can use both the right and the left hand effectively.
Well, Breeden was swatting, so he committed the foul. That's his first on Lawson at the line.
About the only thing about this young man is a point guard that you want at the end of the game because he can break people down as the clock runs down. He's only a 66% free throw shooter. Now we're seeing a little squawking here by Florida State. The referees ought to bring that to a close in a hurry.
Well, that's what Mike Woods is saying right now.
They're all smiling, so I guess that his report was really got their attention.
Now Lawson makes both free throws, so it's a 32-26 ball game.
About a 7-second differential, so North Carolina will get the ball back, even if Florida State went to home for the end.
Swan takes it up. An offensive foul. Took it in with the big guys. Offensive foul, and Swan now has three personals. So Rich has three, Swan has three.
And I would imagine North Carolina holds it to the end, lets Lawson get the ball in his hand and make something happen.
Now you're going to see a guy for Florida State who very rarely plays. Josue Soda comes into the ball game, and Swan will sit down.
Now, if Soda takes Lawson, that should play a little bit, and he will. That should play a little bit in the North Carolina's hands. You're talking about an inexperienced guy who's just coming fresh off the bench.
Freshman from Jacksonville is right there on Lawson. He's intense. I'll tell you that. Look at his face.
He is intense. He's looking him right in the eye, but he also is looking for the screen.
Now it's a nice move.
Absolutely beautiful fake.
Lawson takes it away. Thompson with the follow. It'll count.
Oh, Leonard Hamilton's worst nightmare. And he gets a technical foul, Tim.
He was sold. Now there's a technical foul that's going to be shot on the bench. It'll be a two-shot foul when we come out here in the second half. You talk about a big, big turnover. Great play by Ellington. Then Lawson is going to anticipate the inbounds pass. He makes the steal right here. Now, at this point, Leonard Hamilton is really angry. You see the basket counts, and Leonard is off to the left. He makes a move, and the referee makes a move on him. So you're going to have North Carolina with a 10-point lead coming out, shooting two free throws to start the second half.
Wow. What a finish to the first half.
Every time Carolina would pull away, Florida State reeled them back in. But they are in some trouble now at intermission.
Will be attempted to start the second half.
Mike and Cliff on the other side.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by your Carolina Chrysler dealers, by Red Lobster, by Q Motor Oil, by Charles Schwab, by Sonic Drive-In, and by RBC Centura. Ruby Tuesday presents the play of the first round. Last night in double overtime, Army Hill of Wake Forest hit the game-winning three-pointer with 26.5 seconds left for the 114-112 victory in our Ruby Tuesday play of the first round.
Wow, what an end to the first half here this first game, North Carolina. And they're up 10, and there's one of the great teams in North Carolina history. The 1957 championship team is here, a team that was coached by Frank McGuire, went unbeaten, and some members of that team were here. They had that great triple overtime win over Wilt Chamberlain and the Kansas team, and it was a, I think it was the beginning of great things in the Atlantic Coast Conference.
No question about it. You see Joe Quigg there. He hit the foul shots to win the championship. At the end, North Carolina needs that in this particular game because they've been missing those foul shots. Can they get Joe Quigg in for a little recurrence there?
Yeah, he did. He hit those big, big free throws. Now, let's take a look at some other scores. Our Bud Light scoreboard, our Budweiser scoreboard, and in the Big Ten, Ohio State leading Michigan at halftime. You heard Billy talking. Michigan needs that win to get in the tournament. Kansas and Oklahoma pretty close early in that game. North Carolina up by 10, and what an end of the half it was. Ellington with a big three right there. Free throw shooting was a story in this first half. North Carolina just 6 for 14 from the line. Florida State is 8 for 8 from the free throw line, and this is just the beginning, Cliff. Four great games today, and we've got two of the newer members of the league coming up in a moment. Miami-Boston College after this North Carolina-Florida State game.
Well, what I remember about that rivalry in football is Doug Flutie making a Hail Mary pass to win a football game many, many years ago. But at the same time, this Miami team proved its worth yesterday, crashing the glass, and they'll be game going into this Boston College game this afternoon. Should be one heck of a game.
Yeah, Flutie, by the way, a big basketball fan. Wouldn't be surprised to see him here at this game. But we'll be back to talk more about this game, Florida State and North Carolina. Al Thornton with 9 in the first half.
This moment in ACC history is presented by Geico. Saturday, in a 98-90 overtime victory against Miami, Al Thornton of Florida State scored 45 points. It was a career high for the senior and was the highest scoring total by an ACC player this season. Congratulations to Al Thornton of Florida State for marking his moment in ACC history, presented by Geico.
Halftime, and it is Florida State. With just 8 field goals in the first half, they shot the ball only 32%. And Cliff, despite that, though, they kept this game even fairly early.
Until right then, but the problem that Florida State had was with some turnovers. But right off the bat early on, you see the slip of the screen. Look at this ridiculous reverse by Al Thornton. There's so many things that he can do. For North Carolina, we talked about pounding the basketball inside. You see that happen. And from the bonus sphere, they've been able to knock down some shots. Here's the end of the half play that really sent Leonard Hamilton on a rage. And the second half's going to start with technical fouls. But Leonard Hamilton, hotter than July on the sidelines, or hotter than Tampa.
Hotter than Tampa. It's going to be 80-some degrees outside today, and I'm sure the temperature really rose, as you can see there. Let's take a look now at our first half stats in this game. And you can see the turnovers were a huge story, 12 on the part of Florida State, 8 for North Carolina, and the shooting percentages we talked about.
Well, you see that how important it's going to be for Florida State to cut down the turnovers. It's going to be valuable.
Right. Well, you can't leave here without a souvenir. We're going to get one while we listen to Tim and Billy start the second half.
ACC Basketball is brought to you by Chevrolet, by Gatorade, by Ruby Tuesday, by Pontiac, by Progress Energy, by Chick-fil-A, and by Toyota.
This game is available in high definition, and it's brought to you by Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports. Check the availability in your area. 13 personal fouls, 12 turnovers. They shot 32%. Florida State definitely struggled and ended that half with a technical. Can they get back into it, Billy?
I really don't think so. Tim, what is going to really be interesting to me to start the second half, who does Roy Williams pick to shoot the free throw?
Not Terry.
Danny, well, now wait a minute. I'm going to throw out a wild idea here. Danny Green is the best free throw shooter that they've got. And I think he went over the referees. I think he may be the guy to shoot him. But you know what? I may have let Terry shoot him. I'll tell you why. You got a 10-point lead. He is a guy that shoots around 80%. Getting back on stride by letting him go out there and shoot two. But we'll see who it's going to be.
Ellington.
It's going to be Ellington, huh?
Let's go over to Scott Perswanson. Scott.
Yeah, obviously, at the end of the half, Leonard Hamilton was very, very frustrated. But, you know, he said, we can't execute any poorer than we did in the first half, so he expects his club to play better. As for Roy Williams, you know, 14 points in the paint for Florida State in the first half, 12 for North Carolina. That's the exact opposite of what happened in Chapel Hill. He wants the ball to go inside and come out. Also asked him about Tyler Hansborough's mask. And I think more than anything, Tyler's just got to get used to it and know he's got to play with it on.
All right, Scott. You know, we weren't really jumping on Terry there. Terry is excellent. Free throw shooter, 79%. But today, just 1 for 6.
Yeah, and that, again, like a lot of my ideas, that would have been a crazy one. Say, guys, 1 for 6. But, you know, you got a 10-point lead. Let him go out there and get feeling good. But, you know, we know the stroke that Ellington has. He's a terrific free throw shooter. And he stepped right up there and buried him. And North Carolina, they count everything they do in practice in terms of shooting of all types. So I'm sure that they know who is the best guy standing on that line.
And Grove gets off to a good start here in the second half. And the largest lead for Carolina.
You know, that charting of practices, Dean Smith was a master at that for so many years. Roy Williams, of course, longtime understudy, picked that up. There is not anything that happens at a North Carolina practice that's not charted and tabulated.
Florida State now needing points, and they need them in bunches. Here's Douglas. Shot clock is down to 10.
That's a tough break for Florida State. As well as they played in that first half, almost had it close. Get it over the top of Wright, that tight to the basket.
Hansborough with the entry pass, and Wright finishes. 9 points for the rookie.
Well, Thornton tried to beat over the top to steal that ball. He knows how important it is to keep the ball out of Wright's hands that close to the basket.
It's incredible, Billy. It was a very close ball game until just right up to halftime, and now all of a sudden, 42-26 Guardians.
Well, I think that's the trademark of any good team, where they can get those sprints right before the half and right as the second half starts.
And another miss. So they went from 30-26 to 42-26 in what seems like a heartbeat. Here's Terry, banks it in.
Great job using the glass. And if I'm Leonard Hamilton, I get a timeout right now. This game can be over. And he does.
And Carolina with a much better start after intermission than they had at the start of the game. 18-16 to play. Number one seed looking pretty good.
Well, North Carolina has a team that's got an inside game and an outside game. There's Hansborough on the inside. Wright beats Thornton to the ball. He scores again on the inside. Terry, a real good idea there to pull up and take the soft jumper using the glass. Off to a terrific start here.
Oscar Robertson Trophy finalist. There's Tyler Hansborough, North Carolina. Off to a little bit of a slow start here today, although much better here after intermission. Took it right to the hoop, got the first bucket for the Tar Heels.
And I think that report by Roy Williams is very accurate. He's just going to have to get used to wearing that mask.
Shot is short. Thornton comes up with it. Swan back to Rich.
No place to go. Terrific defense by Terry. Austin had an idea to go into Hansborough, but pretty good job by Etchepi.
And this is last touch by Terry, so it'll be Florida State basketball.
You know, I go back to when Florida State entered the ACC. Remember back in 92 when Sam Cassell with his famous words after Florida State beat North Carolina twice that particular year in conference. Sam Cassell goes into the Dean Dome and he says, this is a wine and cheese crowd.
Remember that.
There has been no wine and cheese served here today by the Tar Heels.
There might be some whining in the stands unless the Seminoles get going here. Thornton, short.
I tell you, great job by Wright.
Great job by Thornton to keep it alive for Rich.
Man.
Two bodies on the floor. Etchefu is still hurting. Thornton is there next to him.
Good idea if you're Thornton, stay down there as long as you can. Take yourself a nice breather. The referees are not going to make you go ahead and get up until you feel comfortable. Florida State could use all the breath that they could get, considering this deep North Carolina team. There was Wright with that excellent defensive maneuver, staying right out there with Thornton. There you see one man down and teammate falls right on top.
Yeah, and Thornton looks tired right now,
too. He is tired. Right. He's having to play both ends of the floor. He's 3-for-11 from field goals. He's bending over, and you can tell a lot of came out of him yesterday. You know, Tim, another thing about Florida State, when you look up at this score, and again, as I said, because of those upsets by the lower-seeded teams yesterday, the ACC will be under the magnifying glass by this committee. They want to finish strong.
Here's Thornton. And Thornton is fouled.
21, White. 2-1.
Shows you how strong he is there, going up in the air and even in the air. He's able to hold the balance to make that pass.
Should have gone ahead and shot it, but instead he passed it, and so it'll be out of bounds.
Could have got himself to the line.
Yep.
And he talked about what a great free throw shooting team this Florida State club is. They were 8-for-8 in the first half. They need to get there more often.
Now Florida State on a drought here. They haven't scored in almost 5 minutes.
Understand who's guarding him. With Thompson, he can get that shot off.
There's a pass to Douglas, and he gets the first bucket of this half for Florida State. Lawson pushes it. Fresh legs.
Pretty nice job, though, by Douglas to get in front of him, which is so hard to do.
Wow. There's a turnover. I think that first round bye doesn't mean something this tournament. Wow. Steal and the foul.
There's Ellington again, starting to move his feet. Yeah, he's always had quick hands and long arms, but now he's starting to move his feet and get in good defensive position, becoming a much more effective defensive player. I'd say in the last 4 or 5 weeks, it's amazing his improvement.
And Douglas picks up his third personal. Rich has three. Swan has three.
And it really helps to have a guy that you know is going to be a double-figure scorer that's not a weak link on the defensive end of the floor.
Ty Lawson takes it right to the rack.
6 foot tall, plays like 6'10 when he goes into the basket. He is a terrific finisher for a small man.
Just tired legs, can't get it out of the hoop. Again, it's short. Lawson, and Lawson finishes it.
Beautiful.
Very nice.
Realized the shot was going to get blocked. Remember we had the play like that in the first half where Terry tried to take it all the way to the basket instead of dumping back.
And it dribbles it off his foot. So, I mean, right now, this 18-2 Carolina run just has Florida State reeling. They're tired. They can't keep up. And the fresh legs of Carolina are now taking over. Telecast, you saw Sugarland perform. Their latest album, Enjoy the Ride, features the hit single Settling and is available now everywhere.
Tim, the score right now, 48-28. That's exactly what the second half looked like at Chapel Hill. 48-28, North Carolina. walking away with that game. Today, that they are shooting 53%, Florida State at 28. It's interesting. With North Carolina wins, they shoot 52%. Their opponents shoot 39.
Right.
See any parallel there?
Absolutely, there's a parallel.
3 second
call. Violation there.
Turnover number 10 for Carolina.
Number 11, Darrell Allen.
Leonard Hamilton, who got that technical foul in the Duke game in which they came back, a tremendous comeback to win in Durham. First time in 16 tries. They had lost 15 straight there, but that technical today isn't going to work out quite the same.
Only one bucket here in the first 5 minutes of the second half.
North Carolina really getting after it defensively. Much pressure legs. It's quite obvious.
Yeah, absolutely. You can see the tired legs of Florida State. Douglas for three. That ball is short, but he's going to go to the line to shoot three as Frazier fouls him. Not a very smart foul.
You're exactly right. No reason. You've got a guy with tired legs. Let him go ahead and shoot that. You see Roy Williams right there. He's saying it better than we did, just with the wind. And Frazier, an experienced player, as we all know, a starter last year, had been hampered by injuries this year. But he knows better. A son of a coach knows better than to foul a guy from that distance who has tired legs.
Douglas gives it a whoa as that ball almost comes back out, but he gets the bucket. And Douglas has 4 points this half.
Douglas had some big games this year. One game that really impresses me, 24 points against Wisconsin. For those of you who have seen Wisconsin play, they really play hard-nosed defense. An experienced backcourt knows how to stay on you. So 24-point game against them is really special. You got to be Drew Neitzel category to have those kind of games.
Those free throws help the Noles case. Carolina picks it right back up. Good movement at this end. Frazier on the baseline.
Not the best move that I've seen.
Thompson has it blocked, but he's fouled. And the foul will be on Etchefu.
That was really good defense by Florida State. They were moving in North Carolina extremely patient. Freshman to freshman. Ginyard, and the ball goes down on the inside. Thompson, we saw make that clever play on the fast break just a few possessions ago. Goes up strong. This young man put on quite a show in that Arizona game. And you know, when you talk about North Carolina, that was probably their most impressive performance of the year. So you talk about their depth and ability to go deep. In that particular game, they had three fellas that have been starters on this team that didn't even play in the game. So any way you want to do it, they're a pretty good basketball team.
About the only weakness we've seen is at the free throw line today. They're below 50%. 8 of 18. Wow.
And that's surprising because they're a 71% free throw shooting team on the year. Thornton goes up and he's fouled.
So Thornton will go to the line.
Thornton probably saying, where are all these guys coming from? I mean, there's Thompson and there's Wright and there's Hansbrough. Stevenson has been in this ball game.
Well, every time he touches it, they double him. Down low like that, there were three there. You're right.
I think he's best against this club, unless Wright's on him, who has those long arms, is to stay outside and use his jump shot or those power moves that he has for the medium range game.
That's Florida State's first miss from the line today. They're 11 to 12. Putting with 9 points.
Jim, we talked about how good a free throw shooting team this Florida State club is. Fifth in the nation.
50 Tyler Hansbrough.
One of the best free throw shooting teams been in the ACC quite some time. Remember that great NC State team of a couple of years ago? Almost shot 80% for the line as a team. They actually win a lot of ball games.
Thompson goes out of the ball game. Hansbrough comes back in. This is Terry, looks inside.
Right court and going after position. Williams is intent about getting that ball into one of his postmen.
He sure is. Hansbrough comes out to greet it.
Tough shot.
Makes it.
Half hook.
Nothing to it. Etchefu and Hansbrough really battled down low.
Well, Etchefu did a good job positioning on that last play. Just Hansbrough just has such a repertoire.
Allen hits the three.
Allen has probably been the best perimeter player for Florida State in these two games.
He's got 10 points, Billy.
Ben looking back inside. Horton's trying to play a one-man zone inside.
Right to Hansbrough. Hansbrough, offensive foul.
Allen goes down. Pretty good fake job. But he had good position.
Hansbrough now has three personals. Let's take a look at our Haviland defensive shield. Dudley Bradley holds UNC's record for most steals in an ACC tournament game. Seven back in 1979. Billy, I know you were there.
Yes, I was for the period of time. I'll never forget Al McGuire. He was picked player of the game. Dudley Bradley or Bradley Dudley? I can't remember what his name was. But Al, he just played in the game. He was the MVP.
That's all right. Al used to call and say, I played for the Turpitans.
Good steal. Little pickup here by Florida State. That's a fool. Hansbrough really going hand-to-hand combat down inside.
Here's Wright. Looks inside.
Florida State doing a nice job now defensively, and there's a hold.
That's three on Thornton. Had the wraparound.
The other thing about it, not only does he have three fouls, he does not want to come out of this ball game, but also the fact that you're battling inside so tough against actually four low post players, Florida State's going to get tired. He did not want to come out.
No, he didn't. He didn't. And I'm not sure he's going to be there long.
Well, Leonard Hamilton watches him walk by. He was the first recruit that Leonard Hamilton had at Florida State. And if you're going to recruit a program builder, Leonard Hamilton did it at Oklahoma State. He did it at Miami. And now he's doing it at Florida State. He can put a program on the map.
White has it blocked.
Nice little run here by Florida State.
Allen can't finish. That's a fool has it blocked.
Oh, nice move by Terry.
And here goes Terry. Look out.
Didn't catch up to him. That was a collision waiting to happen. Terry is such a strong athlete. Some finish.
What a turn of events where Florida State had a couple of really good opportunities. And it's UNC that ends up with the dunk.
They have a chance to get it down to 12. Instead, it goes the other direction.
Almost time for Leonard Hamilton to say, heck with the foul trouble. We got to go with our guys. Forget about tomorrow. They got to get by today. Inside to Hansbrough, tied it. That's jump ball possession out. Florida State and the Seminoles are making a run.
They really are, but are they going to wear down with this run? A lot of energy has been expended.
This is where they had the opportunity. But this turned into a Terry slam dunk. But it's a 12-point game. Well, the Tar Heels led by 20, but it's now a 12-4 run by Florida State. Let's go to the Cook Dogs, Cook.
Well, what I see, North Carolina, it might be wise for them to look at some zone, try to get Florida State standing a little bit. Florida State's been doing an excellent job of moving off the basketball, making things happen. I wouldn't be surprised to see North Carolina play some zone at some point. At the same time, when Lawson's not in the game, Florida State would be wise to trap some.
All right, the fella's dropping some science on us, coaching us up. And Florida State will retain possession. Was it touched by Florida State or Carolina? They're going to give it to Florida State.
Hansbrough just got a little piece of that pass.
He went over to bring the ball in, and now they give it to Florida State. Still fooling with that headband.
Now he's had all kinds of problems adjusting to it here today.
Face mask has two headbands, and he continues to adjust them.
Breeden has played some fine minutes here for Florida State since he's come in. He's fresh. Notice he hit that jumper. Pretty good defense there.
Proud winner of the 5-second ball. Didn't get it. Ball's still loose. Lawson comes up with it. Here's Lawson on Ritz to drop back past the green. And now the foul.
I thought that Ginyard got fouled a couple of times in there on his catch.
Called it on Allen. Terry will come into the ball game, and Green will go out for North Carolina.
replacing number 14.
You know what I think has happened in North Carolina, and this does happen. You know, you get a 20-point lead, you're in a tournament like this, and this game is over, and Florida State, fortunately for them, they have not given in. They haven't mailed this baby in. They keep playing hard.
But Billy, they didn't call a foul in their last play. They were saying Allen was out of bounds. So, of course, they bring it in, the inbounds pass, and it's 52-40.
That was Ginyard on the tap, and he waited till the ball got outside the cylinder. Wise play on his part.
And that makes it 54-40. Here's Allen for three. Not even close.
Might have been a step or so out of his range.
That was right and short.
Push from behind.
And that's all Breeden.
You know, it is interesting. The team makes a run like this, as Florida State did. They can expend so much energy, and then all of a sudden they hit the wall. You see that happening right now. Breeden goes out.
Thornton goes back in. So we'll see what Thornton does here. The last 10 and 12.
Etchefu coming in as well. You know, these two teams met once in the Final Four. Was back in the days when Florida State was independent. 1972. A guy named Reggie Royals, a kid from North Carolina, was one of the leaders on that Florida State team, and they beat North Carolina in the NCAA Final Four semis, and then went on and lost to Bill Walton his sophomore year at UCLA. That was a great Florida State team. Hugh Durham, their coach.
That was a great young UCLA team.
Absolutely.
And this foul is called on Thornton. So he comes right into the ballgame and picks up his fourth.
And not what he needs to be doing right now. He needs to save his energy and his ability on the offensive end of the floor. If anything, to pick up a foul, it might be in the charging play where you're making a good move for the basket. His team cannot afford him to pick up the foul. Still 9 minutes to go in this game.
Seminoles down 14. Here's Lawson. Back to Terry. Fires from three.
And that's a point. He might not have hit those free throws in the first half, but he looks pretty good in the second half with a jumper.
And he's in double figures with 10 points.
And we mentioned in the first game, he did not score against Florida State. Didn't have a field goal or a foul, which is unusual for him.
Here's Thornton. Squares up, loses the handle.
Wright got a little piece of it.
He did. Shot clock at 10. Florida State, after that run, now can't buy a basket. Lawson kicks it out to Ginyard.
There again was that terrific strength.
And a possession error belongs to Carolina.
You see again, Hansbrough with the mask. Normally would have caught that ball and finished. He's having a lot of problems with him. Pretty nice play.
Quentin Thomas comes in from North Carolina, so it's Thomas, Wright, Hansbrough, Terry, and Ellington on the floor right now for the Tar Heels. Rich goes out of the ballgame for Florida State, and Mims comes in.
Well, Lawson, who has got a lot of strength, he's that first guard. Then you come back Frazier, then you got Thompson. So they can always be in good shape at the point guard spot as far as their ability to stay out there and put on pressure.
Douglas now goes out of the game, and Swan comes in.
You notice every Florida State player was bending over during that little break. Every North Carolina player standing straight up. I want to tell you a little something.
Tells a lot. Thomas throws it away.
Nothing there.
And Thomas commits a foul.
Thank you.
And Allen hurt his arm. And our Chick-fil-A nugget of the game. Most unanimous All-ACC first-teamers, Doug Moe, and of course York, and Lynn Chapel, your old teammate, and Art Heyman, Billy Packer.
Four pretty good players right there.
Billy Packer got some votes, didn't
well,
make it.
Well,
first team.
Luckily got on the first team, but I wasn't in the league of those guys, I can tell you that.
And they had three unanimous this year. I think you only missed it by one vote, didn't you?
I don't know.
Unanimous. Final 14.
Many years ago.
Final 14. Okay.
Shot the ball underhanded in those days. But we did play indoors.
Wore those short shorts.
Yeah.
Bims. Knights it over Thomas and again. Finish. Carolina's got four guys out in front. 4-2.
Oh, yes.
How about that finish by Wright? Oh,
9. Thomas to right. Similar to the play in the Duke game. Thomas with the underhand scoop. Roy Williams just smiling over there because that's one of those, if it works, the coach just turns around and smiles. If it doesn't, let's head to the sidelines. Terrific soft pass, but how about Wright's ability to finish way above the rim?
Watch the elevation.
Wow. That is something. That looked like Grant Hill against Kansas. Remember that?
Yeah,
play?
Sure. Good call. Wow. Well, time out on the floor. As the teams discuss strategy, you should, too, get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck, Charles Schwab. What is he telling them here, Billy? I mean, he's got to be saying this is the last gasp.
Well, I think that Leonard realizes still what's at stake. You want to be as impressive as you can in terms of that Sunday afternoon waiting for that selection committee. His team is not going to win this game. Leonard, as I said, is a great program builder. He is a competitor. You saw at halftime, I realize it backfired on him, but he lost his cool there. Wouldn't have made any difference in the outcome of this game, those 2 points, but he is a competitor. You can look at him right now. You can fry an egg in that forehead. That's he steaming over there, isn't he?
Well, Carolina built that 20-point lead. Florida State made a run, 12-4 run. Now Tar Heels have built it back to 19.
I know, and he is from North Carolina. He's a Gastonia boy.
No points over the last 340. And the drought continues.
Long rebounds, and North Carolina running beautifully.
Thomas again to right.
No. I don't see that call at all.
Player control.
Well, the fans down here in Tampa are out of the ball. This is right outside the arena, Fan Fest.
Well, we're going to see the ACC's top freshman in action right here in a low post. We see him blocking some shots, actually as the secondary defender there. Gets around Thornton for a put down. And then, of course, here on the break, finishes beautifully. One of the things today we saw all of those is, all with the exception of the block, were offensive plays. He's done a terrific job on Thornton today. He's prevented Thornton from having one of those monster games that obviously would have been necessary. There he is again defensively. Florida State was going to win, as I said at the top of the show. Thornton would have to have one of those out-of-the-body experience games, and it's not going to happen.
Exciting for us to think what he can do in the future. Scary for his opponents. So much talent still developing. This is Swan for three.
Florida State has had some good looks. Swan particularly. Tommy Berry's one.
They had missed seven straight, so it's been a long time. See if Florida State can mount a little run here.
We still have 7 minutes to go. I just don't think they would have the energy to pull this game out.
Here's Thornton. Thornton scores. He thought it was a jump stop, but you're right. Too many.
Now, he had already taken what amounted to a half a jump and then tried to do another one. Looks like Allen hurt his ankle.
Allen, he goes out limping, yeah.
Okay, we see Wright down there again having some problems. The only problems he's had today is keeping his shirt in his pants. The official saying that's not tucked in well enough.
Ohio State has pushed its lead to 10 over Michigan.
Ohio State, like North Carolina, fighting for a position to be a number one seed. A little box offense here by North Carolina.
And there's a whistle and a foul.
That's the end of Thornton's
and
college career.
That's going to be five.
That will be the end of his ACC career right there. Certainly a guy that you've got to compliment.
So Al Thornton, the 6'8", 220-pound senior from Perry, Georgia, says so long. He's disqualified with his fifth personal foul. Leaves with just 12 points. And that lady is right. That is a shame.
Now, here's a young man that came in as a redshirt freshman. You see that he's disconsolate over there, but he has served his school and his family extremely well in this league as well. As a freshman, 2.9 points a game, sophomore 9-1, junior 16-1, and then this year the leading scorer of the conference, in my estimation, the best player in the league.
Even the Carolina fans don't want to see him leave.
Now, he has, and he talked about not
getting out of college and staying with his team because he wanted to take this team to the NCAA tournament. Hopefully for a young man like that, he gets an opportunity to not end his career here today. Sunday afternoon will tell that story.
Selection Sunday, always fun. Here's Schmoller again. Drops the jumper. 59-46.
13-point lead by North Carolina.
3-point basket. Number three, Isaiah Swan.
You feel, though, that they can turn it on any time that they want to.
Yeah, you do, don't you? You really do. And they still have fresh legs bouncing around. That's a two ball.
So many weapons. Lawson, just as he did at the end of the first half, looking to steal the inbounds pass. That was more aware of it there.
Ellington having a nice ball game with 15 points.
Very funny, can't they? They're so efficient.
Long three, Rich.
Rich. Explosively.
Lawson gets it right back.
He has got to stop his dribble at half court.
And the foul on Hansbrough.
Stepped out, tried to draw the charge. Probably not a wise play by Hansbrough that far away from the basket.
He's got his fourth personal now.
Nice screening. And there's Rich with the finish. I'd say the vertical leap that Rich has would probably match most guys in the conference that can get up off the floor.
And again, the mask comes off just as quickly as he can get off the floor.
What's going to be important, and this may sound crazy, but he may have to wear that mask all the time just to get used to the feel of it. You know, I'm not talking about all the time.
It's up to eat.
I'm talking about walking around and just getting used to having that thing in his head, because without question,
it's
really bothered him today.
That's a good point.
Wright sits down, a terrific game on his part.
Well, I believe that, I mean, when he came out and warmed up, Billy, I didn't think he was going to wear it at all, because he certainly didn't wear it in warm-ups.
Well, that's something that he really ought to do, because he has got to get used to it. Bad pass.
Breeden couldn't hold on to it, so Lawson brings it back and sets the offense. Here's Ellington.
For three. Boy, Swan upset because his own teammate picked him off. Ellington pushing for a 20-point game here today. Started it off with a nice sweet jump shot.
And a foul.
21.
Give Florida State a lot of credit here. They have not folded up. They were down 48-28. They have not folded to 10 here at all.
Well, they continue to battle. The bucket doesn't count. That was early.
You know, an interesting thing, early this year, they beat Providence. Where did they play them? Here on this floor. It was a home game for them. They could have played on their home court. They wanted to come down here to get a taste of what this court was like. Good thinking ahead when they beat Providence.
So Achifu, a 77% free throw shooter. This is the front end of a 1-1. Lawson with a nice pass down low, and it can't be handled by Terry.
Terry thinking about how he was going to shoot it instead of how he was going to catch it.
Achifu for three.
Florida State making a nice little run here.
66-52. Still plenty of time. State playing on fumes.
Well, I tell you, if you were an offensive rebounder at North Carolina, anytime Ellington shoots, assume that ball is going to stay up around the rim and not bounce out long. He has such a soft touch that his rebounds are going to hang around the rim. So get prepared to be right near the basket area and go up and follow. They are not going to be long rebounds when he shoots the ball.
Thompson picks up his third personal. 4:26 to play. 66-52. North Carolina. Our Chrysler game summary, Billy. Looks like this. Thornton out of the game with 12 points. Ellington, 18 points. You talked about his shooting 6-for-9.
And there is that stat. When North Carolina wins, they shoot about 54% and their opponents at 32. That's exactly how today looks.
With Florida State shot around 50% from the field in their ACC wins. Shot 61% against Maryland, won by 17 in Tallahassee. But today, they've struggled.
you look ahead a little bit, and obviously you think about that Duke-North Carolina game. Oh, wait a second.
Duke's gone.
Isn't that amazing? You know, I mean, it's just,
that was an amazing day.
But just think about talking about the Atlantic Coast Conference tournament, and Duke is not a factor.
Let's go over to Scott.
Like ancient history.
Let's go over to Scott Przewalski.
All right, guys, I'm with one of the stars of the 57 championship team for North Carolina, Lenny Rosenbluth. And Lenny, you were honored at Chapel Hill earlier this year. You get a standing ovation here today. What's it been like for you?
Isn't that great? Everybody remembering us after 50 years, I think that's just tremendous. And we certainly are all honored to be remembered that way 50 years later.
How much do you stay in touch with the Carolina program?
I watch it on TV, I yell at the TV, and I live and die with Carolina.
I don't know if you've ever gone through an experience like Tyler Hansborough is now wearing a mask, but as a player, someone who was inside, can you describe, you know, how that might affect you?
Well, it has to affect him somewhat. I'm sure his breathing is not the best, and he's looking good considering that he had a broken nose just a few days back.
You look like you could still put the basketball in the hole, can you?
If I don't have to run.
One of the best to play for Carolina, guys.
All right, Scott.
You know what's interesting there? Lenny hasn't lived in New York in many, many years, okay? But he has the accent. Frank McGuire brought all of that starting. It was funny when they're out there. Tommy Kearns came over, who's being honored with that group as a legend, which the ACC is now doing. But all of them were New York City guys, and they still have that New York City accent. And I know Frank McGuire, looking down, would be extremely proud. You know, those guys are all together.
Had to be a culture shock when it came down to Chapel Hill for a while, anyway. 12-point game, Billy. Here's Ellington.
Ooh, good block. In that particular case, Terry was looking to pass inside to Ginyard. He didn't realize Edgefru was going to come out that strong. Watch Edgefru come over here, and he eliminated that pass.
Ellington threw it to him, thought he had an open guy, and they closed down on him quickly. Looked for Terry down the lane, knocked out by Breeden.
Breeden has played some fine minutes here for Florida State today. Both ends of the floor. With Thornton out of the ball game, he's going to have to play the rest of the way.
Way outside to Ginyard.
18 seconds down on the clock. North Carolina always comfortable knowing Lawson can break his man down with a dribble.
Yells out some instructions. Listen to 10 on the shot clock. Down to 7. Ellington with 4. This is a 3-ball.
Again, see where that ball comes? Right about 3 feet from the rim because of the soft touch.
All the way to the bucket, and it's blocked. How about the block by Ginyard? Nice pass inside. That's why Edgefru. Lawson. Resets.
Do you like the fight in Florida State? I really do. I think this is tremendous. The competitive nature they're showing right now, not wanting to give in.
Shot clock back down to 10. Lawson finishes.
He is so good at it. How valuable is it? And there are a lot of teams in the country that have players that can do this. Conley from Ohio State. Collison from UCLA. The kind of players, when their team's in trouble, the clock winding down, can put it on the floor, break down their defensive man with a dribble, and make something happen.
Rebound. Terry gets up, doesn't he?
Yeah, he sure does. He's a fine athlete. 6'9", good leaper.
9 rebounds.
See Roy Williams not wanting to get the break going there. Terry probably could have had a good outlet pass. Just wanted to work the clock. Down to 2:30 now. Swan's got his hands going with Lawson.
Shot clock down under 10. Lawson takes it to the rack and it's fouled.
There again, breaking down off the dribble, can go with right or left hand, not afraid of contact.
2:20 to play. Gorgeous day.
Of excellence, then, now, and always.
time, closing the door on Florida State. Red Lobster presents the Nothing But Net shot of the game, Billy.
That was Ellington with a terrific crossover move. He's had an outstanding game. There was the end of the first half. The North Carolina not only getting the jump shot, getting the steal, getting a layup, and then Leonard Hamilton picking up the technical foul, put North Carolina in complete control, and then Ellington came back and hit the two free throws to start the second half, and it's been North Carolina all the way.
Future recruit for North Carolina. Meanwhile, Ellington with 18 points, 11 for Wright, Terry with 10, Lawson with 10, getting scoring bullet from everywhere.
They really are, and of course, they've been able to go deep down onto their bench.
Officials have both coaches together now.
Yeah, they're laughing. You notice that? It's nice to see. I don't know what this conversation is about.
If we win.
That was a little different than the two coaches on the sideline of the game last weekend in North Carolina and Duke over that incident.
A little problem with the shot clock, but it's good to see Leonard Hamilton laughing. The last time he was speaking with the officials, they were throwing a tee on him right before the half.
Well, Leonard knows that he'll just have to sit and wait on Sunday afternoon to see if his team gets in. Last year, they were very disappointed they didn't. 14 teams from the ACC have gotten in the NCAA tournament with conference records under 500. And the lowest to ever get in turns out to be Florida State. They got in with a record in 98 of 6-10 in the conference. So there is precedent there. And I think today and yesterday distinguished themselves as being a fine basketball team. Whether or not they're going to be picked as an at-large remains to be seen.
Well, the trend changed so dramatically last year with the mid-majors, and that certainly became the talking point. But this year, with the strength of schedule, the entire conference, their out-of-conference records, what they get, I mean, you've got to believe that at least seven get in.
So, what are the seven? We know what the five are. Who are the other two? We've got Clemson, Georgia Tech, and Florida State all vying for one of those positions. Harris Thornton has had to sit and watch. And as I said at the top of this show, I really felt North Carolina was just too strong for Florida State, with one exception. If the great player just has a game of his life, that was not to be. There's Hansbrough sitting down.
He's got five. He's disqualified. So that means the two stars of this game, Hansbrough and Thornton, have fouled out.
Well, Hansbrough certainly not satisfied with his performance, but he, without question, has a major excuse there. He's going to have to get used to this playing with this mask.
Billy, I asked you before the game even began about a fatigue factor with Florida State. Of course, you know, it's only the first game that they played yesterday, and they come in here the second game, and you think, okay, well, they'll have fresh legs. But that Clemson-Florida State game yesterday was such a game that was played at a high level. There was a lot of emotion through that game. It took a lot out of this ball.
It really did. And, you know, remember in that first half, Clemson, although they put Florida State on the line, was pressing almost that entire first half. So a lot of energy there. You have a guy like James Mays leading that press for Clemson. They can really wear you down.
70-56 with 2 minutes to play. Tar Heels in complete control. And no hurry. Miller will take it out. Shot clock at 15.
And look to get the ball in Lawson's hands as it gets down inside 10.
And he's fouled. Foul is on Douglas.
23.
In the old days of when there was no shot clock, could you imagine Lawson and Dean Smith's four corners? He would have been.
Reminiscent of Phil Ford.
Yeah, people talked when he was recruited that this is the next Phil Ford. We've heard that kind of talk before. And then you even heard some people say he'll be better than Phil Ford. He is not that yet. I mean, he'd have to have some career to do that. But it would be a lot like Phil Ford was in that four corners. Just impossible to stop.
Reminder coming up next, Miami and Boston College. Miami with the upset win over Maryland, and you have to wonder how much that took out of the Hurricanes.
How much did that take out of the Maryland team? I mean, I think it
took out two seats. I think they dropped two seats.
I would agree, and I would not want to be at that Gary's next practice. I guarantee you that team is going to have to really be working.
I think Gary Williams was very disappointed in the effort his guys put forth yesterday. And in the post-game press conference, he was saying, hey, listen, we're still together. We're still a unit. And I don't think that was ever questioned. But I think he was disappointed the way they came out and started that game.
There's no question about it. And particularly when you look at the rebound statistics in that game and the bench production by a Miami team that had been depleted by injuries. They just wanted the game more than did Maryland.
Maryland Terrapins go as DJ Strawberry goes. And in that first half, five turnovers, no assist from Strawberry yesterday. Kind of pretty much set the table.
And unlike him, because he has been one of the hottest players, not only in the league, but in the country.
1:20 to play in the game.
North Carolina just happy to use up some clock. Florida State about out of legs as far as chasing.
And now the shot clock's at 10. And so Frazier now will go.
Frazier's not going to break you down off the dribble like Lawson can.
Oh, Ginyard will. Offensive. Offensive foul on Ginyard.
There's your Pepsi players. Allen and Ellington, and I think good choices there. Thornton did not have the monster game today. Allen, though, played extremely well yesterday with his jump shots. Without question, Ellington was so smooth today, right from the start.
Thompson goes out.
Number 15, Dewey Burke.
And Dewey Burke checks in. That always gets a big round of applause from the Carolina faithful. Burke, a six-foot senior from Philadelphia.
Now, he started in the last ball game against Duke as the tradition in North Carolina senior start.
Douglas has his shot blocked. And now the fans are going to see if Dewey can get a shot.
Now, twice this year, I believe it was twice, maybe three times, he put the team over 100 points. So everybody got a special meal. So the fans really rooted for him.
32 seconds left.
Seven times North Carolina this year scored over 100 points.
Seven on the shot clock. Pass inside. Copeland is fouled. So the foul on Allen.
You know, here's an interesting thing. When you see a team as deep as North Carolina, now Copeland comes on the bench. I believe this is the first time I've seen him in action this year, although I've done a number of Carolina games. Here's a young guy that, at some school, this might sound like a crazy statement, at some school that will get into the NCAA tournament, he would be the starting center.
I agree with you. Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I'd go along with it.
Yep. And maybe even some school that is picked as an at-large team. He may be a starter. And obviously, he would, by this time, have a lot of game conditioning to him, and probably would have a lot more of not only experience, but confidence.
Parker, I know you're headed out to the Midwest. I just want to tell you how much I enjoy, what a pleasure it is to work with the best analyst in the game.
Same with you, Tim. It's always fun working with this entire crew. It's a great thing to be involved with the Atlantic Coast Conference in this incredible tournament. Some history.
Head to Copeland, and that should just about do it. We're under 10. Just let it play out.
Wow, that was a long one.
And that'll do it. So the number one seed advances. The Carolina Tar Heels eliminate the number nine seed Florida State Seminoles, 73-58. We've got Mike Hogwood and Cliff Ellis on the other side. Billy, be safe in your travels, partners. Thanks. Always great being with you.
Same here, Tim. Thanks.
Once again, the final score, 73-58, Carolina. We'll be back right after this.
Carolina beats Florida State despite a subpar performance from their center, Tyler Hansbrough, who's now with Scott Przewanski. Scotty?
Well, Tyler, I know all week long everyone's asking you about your nose and the mask. You know, instead of us speculating, how did it feel out there and did it affect you in any way?
You know, it affected me a lot. You know, it's not comfortable. You know, it rubs on your face. You know, it affects my vision. But, you know, my teammates stepped up and played well tonight. But, you know, at times it was frustrating. I just had to play through it.
Do you think you're going to wear it again tomorrow?
Yeah, I'm going to have to wear it. You know, the doctors strongly recommend me wearing it. You know, I really don't want my whole nose shifting over to the right or left. So I think it'd be in my best interest to wear it.
Aside from the nose, how do you think your team played today and will continue to play on from here on out?
I think we played okay. You know, we didn't play our best game. I don't think we even played good. I think there's some things that we're going to improve on and get some momentum into the game tomorrow.
Tyler, thanks for your time.
Thanks.
Okay, that's Tyler Hansbrough. We'll
say thank you. He's got 6 points, 4 rebounds today for Tyler Hansbrough. Miami, Boston College on the floor, getting ready for our next game. We'll be back in just a moment.